Assalamualaikum, salam sejahtera semua. Apa khabar? So, hari ni kita nak pergi kepada topik baru which is electricity. Tapi, before we want to go further about this topic, teacher nak buat sedikit revision. Do you still remember about electron? Ingat lagi tak electron di Form 1 Chapter 6? Alright? Electron is a subatom. Electron can move. Electron negatively charged. Ingat ya? So, sebelum nak masuk, memang you kena faham berkaitan dengan electron dulu. Because in electricity, you tak boleh lari daripada electron. Electron is a very important person, VVIP dalam cerita electricity. So, always remember, electron is a subatom. Electron can move, selalu bergerak, always move. Electron is negatively charged, bercharge negative. So, dah settle berkaitan dengan electron? Jom kita masuk electricity. Alright. Dalam kehidupan seharian kita, in our daily life, kita tak boleh lari, alright, from using electricity. Even kita nak masak pun pakai electricity sekarang kan, ada induction cooker, nak charge telefon. Nah, macam cikgu sekarang nak buat video kan, cikgu kena charge dulu telefon cikgu ni. Alright, using electricity. But what is electricity? Alright, what is electric? Dekat sini cikgu dah sediakan dah. Alright, electric is when electron move in a conductor from point A to point B. So, teacher simplifikan dalam bentuk gambar kat sini. Alright, kita ada two point, point A, point B. Alright, the movement of electron, alright, the movement of electron from point A to point B in a conductor. Alright, so this movement of electron from point A to point B in a conductor, we know it as electric. Boleh faham ya? Alright. Kenapa cikgu tekankan conductor? Kat sini. Can water plus can plastic bottle ni conduct electricity? Cannot. Sebab dulu kita dah belajar bahawa only metal, alright, conductor can conduct electricity. Maksud conduct electricity ni maksudnya membenarkan elektrik itu mengalir melaluinya. So contoh ni kan, marker ni kan, ni kan besi metal, and then jam cikgu kan metal. So can electricity flow through it? Yes, boleh flow. Boleh faham ya? So ingat, electric is the movement of electron, pergerakan elektron. Elektron bergerak, gerak, gerak, gerak from point A to point B in a conductor, we call it electric. Senang kan? So, now kita tengok pula current. Cikgu, apa dia current? Kadang-kadang mak cakap, woi, hang tutup current sat lah, sat lagi bil api tinggi. Tutup current. Okey, kalau orang Penang ke orang utara, kami suka cakap current. Tapi sebenarnya merujuk kepada electricity. So, in science, what is current? Current is the amount of electron. Berapa banyak elektron, bilangan elektron move in a conductor from point A to point B. Berapa banyak elektron bergerak di point A to point B in a conductor, itulah current. Maksudnya, lagi banyak elektron bergerak, lagi high current. Alright? Cikgu bagi dua situasi kat sini. Alright, the first diagram is actually one electron move from point A to point B. Okay? And another things, another diagram dekat bawah ni cikgu bagi, two electron move from point A to point B. So, from this situation, yang mana satu higher current? Definitely yang di bawah. Why? Because more electron, lebih banyak electron bergerak, lebih banyak electron move, more electron move in a conductor from point A to point B. Lagi banyak electron bergerak pada satu masa, current lebih tinggi. The higher the current. Boleh faham ya? Alright, so now kita pergi kepada voltage. Ha, kadang-kadang kita tengok dekat bateri kan? Dekat bateri ditulis 1.5 volt. Pakai dua bateri 2 volt. 2 volt, 1.5 plus 1.5, 3 volt. Alright? And then ada banyak volt dekat situ kan? Kadang-kadang you punya electrical appliances pun ada tulis okay berapa banyak volt. Alright? Dekat situ dia ada label kan? So what is voltage? Kalau tadi elektrik, elektron nak bergerak. Alright? Current, berapa banyak elektron bergerak. Voltage, paling senang, berapa banyak energi untuk menyebabkan elektron itu bergerak. Alright? Based on your textbook, okay? Based on your textbook, ini istilah textbook yang memang kalau you pakai, you nak jawab dalam exam, you kena pakai this one. Alright? Refer to page 146, dia ada tulis dekat sini. Dia ada tulis. Okay. The voltage is the potential difference between two points. Alright? Between two points. The voltage is the potential difference between two points. Okay. Tadi kan kita ada bincang berkaitan dengan elektrik bergerak daripada point A to point B. Alright? Potential difference ni adalah keupayaan elektron itu to move. Untuk dia berupaya nak move from point A to point B, elektron tu mesti ada tenaga, supply, alright? Energy supply, alright? Energy supply ni kita panggil dia voltage. So, cikgu ringkaskan lah ya untuk pemahaman, untuk cikgu fahamkan awak. Voltage is energy that need to push an electron to move in a conductor from point A to point B. Energy that need to move the electron. Tapi, in your textbook, you kena jawab dalam exam keluar what is voltage? You kena cakap voltage is the potential difference between two points. Boleh faham? Okay? So, cikgu simplifikan balik what is electric, current and voltage. Electric, electron move in a conductor from point A to point B. Current, how many electron move from point A to point B in a conductor? Alright, the more electron move, the higher the current. Voltage, alright, kita tengok voltage. Voltage is energy that need to push the electron from point A to point B. Settle. Senang kan? Alright, so now kita pergi ke last part of this topic, which is resistance. What is resistance? Resist, stop. Tahan, halang. Alright, itulah resist. Resist, menghalang. Alright, so resistance is the ability of a conductor to limit or resist. To limit, untuk mengehadkan, or resist, untuk menghalang the flow of electric current. Okay, tadi kita katakan current is the movement of electron kan? So, resistance dia menghalang pergerakan elektron tersebut. Okay, boleh faham? So now, tadi kita dah discuss electric, kita dah discuss current, kita dah discuss voltage. Rupanya, kita ada device yang untuk bantu detect how many current, how much voltage semua. Ada device dia. Now, kita tengok current. Current, we can use ammeter. Alright, we can use ammeter. And the unit for current is ampere, symbolized as capital A. Okay, now we go to voltage. We can use voltmeter, symbolized as V capital. And the unit is volt. 1.5 volt, 3 volt, 4.5 volt. Resistance, we can use resistor or rheostat. And the unit for resistance is ohm, symbolized as this one. Boleh? So, don't forget to press the description button because dekat description button, I give you one link video that shows you the animation of electricity. Alright, from that video, you can see that the movement of electron in a conductor from one point to the other point. Very interesting video. So, jangan lupa tekan di bahagian description untuk dapatkan link video tersebut. Dan kita jumpa lagi dalam video seterusnya. Bye! Assalamualaikum!